Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about the Aronhold-Kennedy theorem for a particular mechanism which is related to motion. It can be linear motion, it can be rotation, or it can be combined motion. So let's start the discussion of Aronhold-Kennedy theorem. Basically, Aronhold-Kennedy theorem we generally consider for a structure which consists three links, and three links are in relative motion. So as per the Aronhold-Kennedy theorem, if three bodies move relatively to each other, they have three instantaneous center lies on a straight line. Basically, if we consider three links which are connected to each other with the help of different way like pin joints, and all the links are forming turning pair. So, three links generally make a structure or a rigid structure, and structure cannot move at all. So, here if we are considering three bodies which are relatively moving with each other, so they have three instantaneous center because there are three contact points for three links we will consider. And all the instantaneous center, if we define, so all the instantaneous center must lie on the straight line as per the Aronhold-Kennedy theorem. So let's consider three links, link A, link B, and link C. And all the links are connected to each other. Here link A and B are connected at this particular point. Link A and C are connected at this particular point. And link B and C are connected at this particular point. So all the links are connected by three joints. Here three links with three joints. So, if we want to define the number of instantaneous center, so number of instantaneous center we can define with the help of formula. So, this is the formula by which we can define the number of instantaneous center for a mechanism. So, in this mechanism, if we have three links, so mechanism we can define by fixing one link. So we can fix either link A, link B, or link C. So if we are not fixing, so it will be a kinematic chain. So here we have three links. So on the basis of these three links, we can define the total number of instantaneous centers. So, here we have three number of links where n is representing the total number of links in a mechanism. So, total links we have three. So, on the basis of this formula, we can define the total number of instantaneous center, that is 3 into 3 minus 1 by 2. So, total number of ICs or instantaneous center we have three. So, we can mark these instantaneous center on the link. So, as you can see here, we have three links. So, at every joint, we can mark the instantaneous center. So, here for A and B, we will mark instantaneous center IAB. For A and C, we will mark instantaneous center as IAC. And for B and C, we will mark instantaneous center as IBC, and these instantaneous center will be permanent in nature. Here we are not fixing any link, so this particular joint, this joint and this joint, all joints are considered, or it is forming a turning pair for the respective links. So these two links can move with respect to this particular point IAB, IBC, this BC link can move with respect to this particular point or joint, and IAC is the point about which this link C and A can move. So these are forming a turning pair, and at the turning pair point we can, or this joint is representing the turning pair for these two links. So at these points we can define the instantaneous center, and these links are in moving condition. So these instantaneous center will be permanent type of instantaneous center. Now if we are fixing one link, for example, if we are fixing this link A. So this IAB and IAC we will consider as a fixed instantaneous center. Now, as per the Aronhold-Kennedy theorem, it is defined if three bodies are moving relatively to each other, they have three instantaneous centers. So here we have three bodies A, B and C, and they are moving relative to each other about three different points, and they have three instantaneous center. So as per this formula, we can define the number of instantaneous centers. So number of instantaneous centers are 3 only. And the last line is all the instantaneous center lie on a straight line. So here, whatever instantaneous center we are defining for these 3 links, all the instantaneous center will lie on the same line. Like IAB and IAC are lying on the same line, this particular line IAC, IAB. So this third instantaneous center IBC will also lie on this line IAB, IAC. Let's define this line as PQ, QR and PR. So all the instantaneous centers must lie on the line PQ. So as per this theorem, Kennedy theorem generally representing IAB, IBC, IAC, it should be lie on a same line, that is line PQ. Now here in this diagram, we are considering IBC is the instantaneous center for B and C. Now let us consider this IBC is not lying on the same line PQ. It is lying away from this line PQ, or all the instantaneous center are not collinear. Here this is the position we are considering for IBC. So in that condition, these three links are in relative motion. So here, if we are not fixing any link, so all the instantaneous center will be permanent type and all the links are in relative motion. So we have to mark these instantaneous center on different link. So here a third instantaneous center which is not lying on the same line, this is IBC. So this IBC if we are considering on link B, or this line PR. So we are considering either line IAB or IBC or line PR, and this is the position of instantaneous center IBC. So this particular link PR is in relative motion, and here let's consider this is the direction of motion. So if we are taking the linear velocity for this particular point B with respect to point C, so the relative velocity or the linear velocity we can consider in this direction. And for another link, if we are considering this particular instantaneous center IBC is lying on another link RQ. So here we are defining two different positions of IBC, on link or line PR and another on link RQ or line RQ. But we cannot define two different positions of one instantaneous center. Here if we define the velocities or linear velocity of this particular instantaneous center IBC, so here if we are considering on PR line, so the velocity vector or the direction of linear velocity for PR or IAB, IBC will be perpendicular to PR. And if we are considering this particular line RQ or line IBC, IAC, so the relative velocity or the linear velocity we will consider perpendicular to this line RQ or IBC and IAC. So, for both the condition, velocities or linear velocity are perpendicular to different line. For first condition, it is perpendicular to PR for this condition. And for second condition, this VBC is perpendicular to RQ. And during motion, we cannot consider any particular linear velocity perpendicular to two different lines, or instantaneous center, which we are considering on this point, it should not be different for both the lines which are joining at the same point. If two lines are joining at the same point, so instantaneous center we will consider at one point only. So, and since this is a structure, because it has three links, and if we are considering three links are connected at three different points, so it will convert in a structure. So, for structure, we don't consider any kind of motion. So, for this rigid structure, as per this particular concept, and as per the single instantaneous center for the joining point, we can say any structure should have all the instantaneous center at one single line only. So, as per these three concepts, we can define the Aronhold-Kennedy theorem. All the instantaneous center for the three links which are in relative motion, it should lie on the single line. So, here IAB and IAC are on the same line on PQ. So, this IBC also should lie on the same line. Thank you so much.